Hi guys, welcome to Number X. Today we are going to learn about expressing any function as the sum of an even and an odd function. If you enjoy this video, don't forget to like it and subscribe to our channel. Post any questions or suggestions you have in the comments below. So let's get started. The knowledge of splitting the function into sum of an even and an odd function is very useful while performing definite integrals of functions which are neither even nor odd, and lower and upper limits are additive inverse of each other. Suppose we want to find integral of the function 1 over e to the sin x plus 1. This function is neither even nor odd. I am sure that you can check it yourself. Recall that integral of an odd function with limits that are additive inverse is equal to 0, and integral of an even function with limits that are additive inverse is equal to 2 times the integral of the given function with lower limit 0 and upper limit a. We will use this concept to solve this problem at the end of this video, but for now let us learn how to split a function which is neither even nor odd into sum of an even and an odd component. Let y is equal to f of x is a continuous function in its domain. Algebraically, it can be written as sum of g of x and h of x, where g of x equals sum of f of x and f of negative x whole divided by 2, and h of x equals difference of f of x and f of negative x whole divided by 2. Can you believe that g of x is an even function and h of x is an odd function? Let us verify it. Substituting x by negative x in g of x, we get f of negative x plus f of negative x whole divided by 2. You can further reduce it to f of x plus f of negative x, which is equal to g of x. This implies g of x is an even function. Similarly, we can check that h of x is an odd function. So we have decomposed f of x into its even and odd components, where g of x is an even component and h of x is an odd component. For example, let f of x equals e to the x. This function is neither even nor odd, but we can easily split it into even and odd components. Since even component, that is g of x equals f of x plus f of negative x whole divided by 2, by substituting f of x by e to the x and f of negative x by e to the negative x in this equation, we get even component. Similarly, we can find odd component of the given function. You can verify this fact by graphing g of x and h of x on graphing calculator. Since graph of g of x is symmetric about y-axis, hence it is an even function, and graph of h of x is symmetric about origin, this implies it is an odd function. At this point of time, you have fully understood the method of splitting the function into even and odd components. Let's get this idea in the mathematical form. Let f of x is a function which is equal to sum of its even and odd components, that is g of x and h of x, and we want to find its integral with lower limit negative a and upper limit positive a, where a is greater than 0. We can replace f of x by sum of g of x and h of x, and further it can be written as sum of integrals of g of x and h of x without changing lower and upper limits. Since g of x is an even function, hence it can be written as 2 times integral of g of x with lower limit 0 and upper limit a, whereas integral of h of x will be 0 because it is an odd function. So, integral of f of x with lower limit negative a and upper limit positive a is equal to 2 times integral of g of x with lower limit 0 and upper limit a. We will use this result to solve the initial problem, which is integral of 1 over sum of e to the sin x and 1 with lower limit negative pi by 2 and upper limit pi by 2. Let f of x is equal to integrand This function is neither even nor odd function. However, we can find even component of this function. Let g of x be even component of f of x, then g of x equals f of x plus f of negative x whole divided by 2. By substituting the value of f of x and f of negative x, we get g of x equals 1/2. Now integral of given function is equal to 2 times integral of g of x with lower limit 0 and upper limit pi by 2. Further, this integral reduces to pi over 2. By end of this, we have finished this lecture. To get more videos like this, please subscribe to our YouTube channel Number X and hit the like button. You can share this video to other person and provide your valuable feedback in the comment box. So thanks for watching, and I am looking forward to see you in the next lecture.